Being here and volunteering, and really that's two separate things. Being here and just being in this environment is really, really cool. And volunteering and working with kids is something that I really like to do. I was interested because it's a lot like what I used to do when I was a child, and I was, being around the water and crabbing and fishing and all that stuff. And kids that come here get an experience that they really don't get a lot of other places, particularly nowadays when kids are not outside as much and so forth. And I got those experiences when I was younger, being around the water all the time and growing up on the Severn River, actually, and crabbing and fishing and so forth. And they get to come here and we lead them through activities and teach them about those same kinds of things.
I really enjoy volunteering at SERC because it really feeds my love of nature and my love of teaching. When I was a kid, I grew up in the suburbs of Cleveland, Ohio, but there were some woods near my house, and every day it would find me wandering through those woods. There was a creek nearby where I would spend hours and hours mucking around, turning over rocks, looking for salamanders and things like that. So SERC, to me, allows me to pursue those same passions, nature and teaching.
One of the cool activities that we do here with the kids is called seining. And it's probably the most popular activity, actually, because the kids get to put on chest waders and actually go out into the water using a net called a seine and drag it across the bottom and bring it up on the beach. And usually there's a lot of animals in there. There's fish and crabs and shrimp, and we've caught as interesting things like horseshoe crabs even, in these nets right here on this beach. So it is one of the most important things that we use to teach the kids. And the main message here is biodiversity. We want the kids to understand that a lot of animals live here and they all have relationships with each other and they're all important.
I also work on the citizen science side, where everyday people like me can help the researchers here at SERC with their work in the field or in the lab. One of my favorite stations here that we take the kids through on field trips is called the Oyster Station. Kids learn a lot about oysters that not even adults know. They learn that they're important filter feeders, but also that they provide habitat for smaller animals. The way we teach kids that is we hang baskets over the side of the dock for a week or so, and the baskets have oyster shells in them. During that week, the little critters move in and occupy the spaces, and we have the kids pick through the baskets to find those critters. And usually the most common critter they find is a tiny little mud crab. They look like crabs, but they're tiny. Scientists here at SERC are doing research on a parasite that has invaded the mud crab in Chesapeake Bay. And the parasite essentially takes over the mud crab and convinces the crab to raise the parasite's eggs as its own, so thus hurting the mud crab population and blowing up the parasite population. This particular project is near and dear to my heart because this was the very first volunteer thing I did here at SERC.
They get an experience that they've never had before. And that's one of the most rewarding things for me too, is to see their reaction when they do that, when they do something they've never done before and didn't think they could do at all. And here it is, and they do it, and they're just so excited. Some of them are jumping up and down or whatever, and it's really cool. As a volunteer for me, that's the reward. That's the reward, seeing the light in their eyes when they do something they've never done before and didn't think they could do at all. Work with kids that are really excited to be here, but not only that, I learn something every time I come. I'm always learning and getting exposed to really excited kids, so it's fun.
One of the things we do is we talk to them about what they can do in their own day-to-day lives to help preserve the quality of the watershed and therefore the Chesapeake Bay system.
Yeah, the Four Rivers Heritage Area in Anne Arundel County is really important. We are all tied to the water in some way. It's important to understand how nature works land and water together and the impacts that we have on it so that we can preserve the heritage that we find. There's so much history in this area and so much nature that's available to us. We need to understand how it is so that we can preserve it.
There's reason to be optimistic about the bay. And some of the research I've been helping out here has shown that oysters are recovering. Of course, it's gradual and it's step by step, but they are recovering. There are lots of things to feel positive about, and the work here at SERC is an important way of tracking those developments and promoting them.